true heart of a man. And tonight we want the show to be man-led. We want men to be able to speak from the front and really, you know, talk to us as women. We want to hear their hearts. We want to hear their true positions as it relates to relationships. So tonight, hold on to your seats. It's going to be edgy. It's going to be transformational. It's going to be real. He say, she say. I just want to say a special shout out to our listeners. Good night to our minister, Ishmael Watkins. A blessed good night to you, sir. Good night, Fidel Carter, Dr. Jeffrey Gay, Terry Clark, and all those, Hazel Charles, all those, Sandy Paris, Pastor Jason, and all you who are always locked on to Speak Life Radio. I want to say good night to you. Wherever you are, whatever it is you're doing, I pray that you will be home safely and, you know, home soon, because you are just a few, what, about an hour or so from lockdown. And even as we go into the another wave of lockdown, you know, I pray that as we come to you from Speak Life Radio, that we'll be able to bring you hope, that we would be able to bring you inspiration, that we would be able to bring you comfort and peace, knowing that we can go through any storm. As long as we have Jesus on our boat, we can get through the storm and we can come out on the other side. So even as we prepare for our program tonight, he says, she say, I want to share this song with you. And the title of the song is He Say, She Say. And even as you listen to the lyrics of this song, I pray that as we come back to you with the program, that you'll be truly locked on. And I pray that something that would be shared tonight would truly be a blessing to you. He say, she say.
Brother without the R and he's starting to harbor. Cool on fool for thought, but for you he's a starver. Starting to use red markers on his work. His teacher said he know he's much smarter, but he's hurt. Used to hand his homework in first, like he was the classroom starter. Burst of tears, let him know she sees. Now he's fighting in class. Got a note last week to say he might not pass. Asked me if his daddy was sick of us, cause you ain't never pick him up. You see what his problem is. He don't know where his papa is. No positive male role model to play football or build railroad models. He's making a hole and you've been digging it, cause you ain't been kicking it since he was old enough to hold bottles. He wasn't supposed to get introduced to that. He don't deserve to get used to that. Now I ain't asking you for money or to come back to me. Some days it ain't sunny, but it ain't so hard. Just breaks my heart when I try to provide and he say, mommy, that ain't your job to be a man. I try to make him understand that I'm his number one fan, but it's like you born from the stands. You know the world is out to get him, so why don't you give him a chance? It's like
I can't, I won't.
I want you to be a father. I'm your little boy, and you don't even bother. Like, brother without the aura, and I'm starting to harbor. Cool on food for thought, but for you, I'm a starver. Starting to use red markers on my work. My teachers say they know I'm much smarter, but I'm hurt. I used to hand my homework in first, like I was the classroom starter. Burst of tears, let him know he sees. Now I'm fighting in class. Got a note last week to say I might not pass. Kids ask me if my daddy is sick of us, cause you ain't never picked me up. You see what my problem is, that I don't know where my papa is. No positive male role model to play football or build railroad models. It's making the hole and you've been digging it, cause you ain't been kicking it since I was old enough to hold bottles. Wasn't supposed to get introduced to that. I don't deserve to get used to that. Now I ain't asking you for money or to come back to me. Some days it ain't sunny, but it ain't so hard. Just breaks my heart when my mama try to provide and I tell her that ain't your job to be a man. She try to make me understand that she my number one fan, but it's like you born from the stands. You know the world is out to get me, why don't you give me a chance? It's like
I can't, I won't.
To He Say, She Say, and tonight we have in our studio Dr. Dale Brathwaite and Mr. Fidel Carter. They're going to be our special guests on the show tonight, and we want to have a really good discussion tonight. And like I said to you earlier, we want this show to be male led. We want to hear what men have to say tonight. We want to hear what the men got to say. Yeah, so ladies, buckle your seatbelts. It's time for us to, you know, gag it up. We're not talking tonight. We want to hear what the men have to say. So my role here tonight on He Say, She Say is simply to ask probing questions and to be the host for these brilliant gentlemen who's going to come and share with us tonight on the whole topic of beyond the ATM man. And we're also going to be looking at what men really want from women, understanding the true heart and nature of a male. Because oftentimes we approach the male, we think of them as if they think and act just like us. So we want to hear from real men tonight. I know sometimes we as women feel that we are men, but we are really not. Newsflash, we are not. We are women, okay? So let me repeat that for those of you in the back. We ladies, we are not men, you know? For those of us who would say, man, I was a mother and a father, it's a lie. We rebuke that tonight in the name of Jesus. It's a lie. So tonight we want to hear from real men, not the women who feel they're men, the real, real men. So without any further ado, I want to introduce my first guest, Dr. Dale Brathwaite. Good night to you, Dr. Dale. How are you doing? Wow, I like that. I like what you said about if God wanted two men in a relationship, he would have made two males. You can take a naturopathic
product for pain or pharmaceutical, and it generally comes up the same for either male or female. But when they're looking at now they're discovering issues of thought patterns, issues of
I like what you're saying. You're saying that if God wanted males and females to be equal, he would have put two men in the relationship. Interesting point. So you're saying basically then that men and women are not equal in relationship. Am I understanding you correctly, Dr. Dale? Brother Fidel, anything you wanted to add to that?
Black men in the past, whereas among the women you'll find a much higher, a lower number when it comes to unemployment. How many women are working for network? In the corporate world, in the university, you'll find many, many more ladies. You'll find a lot of young men in the prison. When I was in high school, it was clear that there was a path to prison being created for the young men who started to. The programs that would have grabbed young men's attention were all removed from the school. All the music programs, the art programs, the carpentry program, everything was removed, and it was just strictly academic. And for a lot of young men, naturally searching for themselves in the school system is to be depressed. But you're a black young man, the only history of your people is race. This is a bit embarrassing. And it's a total different psychology with young men when it comes to learning versus young ladies. For some reason, the young ladies seem to have a lot of vocation and are less likely to, can I say, rebel against what is actually being taught versus just sitting there and listening. You as a teacher, maybe you can give some insight on the difference between male and female schools. And what it is a young man versus a young lady, some people say it. For the sciences, there's a lot of equality because as kids, they learn that young men prefer something practical. They want to, you know, get their hands into it. They get their hands on it, then their interest is peaked out.
Yeah, because the men are tactile. They want to touch it. They want to handle. And that's why, I guess, you find more, you know, in terms of sports and stuff like that, as you rightly said, the way that men engage as opposed to the way women engage. And one of the things that I wanted to share with our listeners tonight is something that you wrote to me about today. And again, a very interesting analysis. I just want to read it so that our listeners can hear. But before I do that, I just want to say good night to my Excel and publisher class. I know you're locked on. Good night to Julia Allen. Good night, Kim Dean. Good night, Pasadena. Shout out to all my Excel and publisher people. Dion, good night to you. Thank you for joining us. And you're locked on to Speak Life Radio. And tonight we are doing our show, He Say, She Say. We've had a lot of discussions about what men want from women. And I promise you that I would deliver a show where you can hear the heart of a man, where men can speak, where we as women can sit back and really listen to understand the true heart of a man. So tonight you're locked on to He Say, She Say. And we have in the studio with us tonight, we have our special guest, Mr. Fidel Carter, and Dr. Dale Brathwaite. So Dr. Dale is going to be joining us back shortly, but in the meanwhile, I want to read to you something that Fidel Carter wrote to me about today. And here it is. My black sisters, we are one people. Your success shouldn't make you unattainable for marriage. Your degree doesn't make you a good or bad wife. It only affects how much you earn. As we fight for success, let's have as many weddings as graduations. Hint, the highest average earning black men are usually in construction and truck driving. That means washing dirty uniforms and cooking good meals so he can handle the physical labor. Can you cook? Is that a ridiculous question? Well, it's a question only us descendants of the enslaved and denatured through slavery would have to ask. That question is a joke to every other culture. Love is such a gamble in Western society. The community success of Jewish, Indian, Asian, and African cultures over Black, American, and Caribbean culture is their ability to get and stay married. The stability of one marriage and a peaceful household will help build wealth and community for generations. We are a spiritual people. Our fight has been against spiritual wickedness in high places. Society separated black women and placed them above black men to cause division and discord. Our men have been ostracized since the 70s. How much money and success can buy our family back? Interesting. Very, very interesting. I'm sure some of the females might be thinking, oh, so we are being defined now by if we can wash dirty clothes and if we can cook. Is that really what we've been reduced to? I'm sure some women might be thinking that way. Fidel, what would your response to that be?
Some husbands and wives are blessed to actually work together. Mm-hmm. They may both be in the same field and they can work together, whether it's in music, in medicine, in athletics, whatever the case may be. They may be two personal trainers. If they're blessed to have that, that's fine. But if you find yourself in a situation where there used to be a time when the woman would trust the man who does that, they would be fed. Stay-at-home wives, etc. Remember, there's so much betrayal that no one is going to teach your daughter to not have her own and be able to support her. Jargon and talk would have promoted at the end of slavery. During slavery, having
black baby if you want because they represent free labor. After slavery, you have that baby, you can't afford that baby, you can't, you know, it's going to make life so much harder. Which is not really true, because for the average person in the United States making $60,000, $70,000 or whatever, economically, definitely, if you're giving up 30% of your income in taxes, you're making $70,000, giving back off the $22,000, $23,000. If you have a child, the way the taxes are made, up until now, it would actually benefit you economically. It wouldn't hurt you economically at all. So that is just a lie. I'm not even speaking on the spirituality of it. And then having paved the way to your success on those bones of those children, the one or two children, how many abortions they have been had, an individual, you paved your way to success, and then, okay, now you have your degree, you have everything, and now you can start to get married, and you have reproductive problems. I just feel like there's a scripture that says, the servant of the Lord must not strive, but be patient towards all men. It says, let's talk about God giving them, the whole verse is not coming to my brain, but it says, they must not strive, but be patient towards all men. Be apt to teach. And it says, that they may recover themselves out of the snare of the devil who are taken captive by him. Of course, I really believe that is a very devilish, psychological trap in the United States that has all trying to succeed, but in the process, the family is shambled, it's being destroyed, and, you know, abortions are being had. And when they tell you that a baby has no value, they turn around and flip on DNA, RNA,
Hi, good evening. Fidel, we have Dr. Dale back on the line with us. And I think you represented well the statistics, and you've done a really good analysis, as you said, when you look at what's happening in the Western world as it relates to families. The mindset, as you clearly said, is that for the black woman, having children, having a family is really not a priority. And we as women, we complain that men don't want to be married, men don't want families and so on. And we often say that men don't care, they don't want to take care of their children and so on. And I want you and Dr. Dale tonight to really, you know, set the record straight and address those issues for me from a men's perspective. Dr. Dale, welcome back. You're back on with us.
Yes, you can hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you. Give me a little bit more volume and I think we're good to go.
Well, let me see if this other microphone would work.
Okay. Well, I think you're coming through pretty clear.
Is coming through clear now?
Yes, you are.
All right. Listen, one of the issues that I think, like I wrote another book, Think Plain Talk on Sex, and now this one, you know, the ATM.
Wait, don't do it so fast. Don't go so fast. You said Plain Talk on...
Plain Talk on Sex.
Plain Talk on Sex. Well, you're talking about one of my favorite topics, so you're going to have to take your time when you're introducing that book, right? Plain Talk on Sex, because for sure... That is one of the issues that plague us as blacks. We're not even comfortable talking about that issue. So I'm glad you've written a book on it. So Plain Talk on Sex by Dr. Dale Brathwaite. That's what you're saying?
Yes.
Good. All right. You could carry on now.
It is on Amazon.com.
Uh-huh.
And one of the reasons I wrote it is that between 2005 and 2008, they're both. We were having across the Barbados shores persons, certain medical practitioners, one professor, honorable guy, as he is called, was writing in support of getting the children to go to the doctor on their own without telling their parents, writing in view of the value of homosexuality, both for male and female. And I was going to a number of meetings with HIV and so forth, and this paper came up. A lot of issues came up, and they started to blame the church. They started to blame the DJs for the prevalence of homosexuality and it going underground and spreading. And when I started to look, I said, God, if I am to look carefully at this thing, any information I find in favor of, I got to release. So it took me 5 years, over 500 books, 13 medical practitioners, 50-somebody proofreaders, and other specialists. And today, I can clearly say, according to the scripture, when you look at the value of the male and the female, there is distinctiveness in gender, even from the perspective of sperm and ovum containing 23 chromosomes. For example, there are 22 of these labeled autosomes and are responsible for most aspects of the individual's development. So these sex chromosomes determine whether the offspring will be a male or a female. You are a man or a woman from ground level, from the contact of sperm with egg. So the man produces two types of sperm. One type, an X chromosome, having a larger head and a shorter tail. Another type is a Y chromosome, so having a smaller head and a longer tail. So the woman produces ova with only the X chromosomes. So for example, if a sperm containing an X chromosome unites with the ovum producing XX combination, a girl is conceived. So if a sperm containing a Y chromosome unites with the ovum producing XY combination, a boy is conceived. So because the Y carrying sperm have a longer tail and a lighter head, they swim faster and may reach the egg, the egg cell, sooner. So for this reason, there is a conception ratio of 160 males to 100 females. However, the male zygote is more prevalent, so that the ratio is reduced to 120 males to 100 females by the time of implantation. So to 110 males to 100 females by full term, and to 105 males to 100 females born alive. So the ratio is basically balanced. So when we look at how the female is designed, she was designed as the complement to Adam, to encircle his life, to produce for God. So her name, Isha, life, the mother of all. When you look at it, Adam then, the father, the progenitor, they had different purposes. So the female was born out of Adam, and when we got an adage that it needs to hurry and correct, that Adam was walking around with a missing rib, not at all. The when God did his laser surgery on Adam, he took out a rib, and in taking out this rib, when you have something called, I think it is like even plastic surgery and so forth, one of the things that happens is that the orthopedic surgeons and so forth go into the rib cage, take out the rib, but leave something there called the periosteum, which causes the rib to grow back each time they go in. So, you know, when you got, you go at these certain restaurants, you're buying ribs, and you see that piece of thing around the rib shank or whatever it is, because of how it is taken out, the rib grows back. So Adam did not have, as it is, a missing rib for a long time. It grew back. So today, when you're doing certain pieces of surgery, that's what you use. The issue then, in looking at Eve, Eve's response to Adam was different from Adam's response to Eve. Adam said, whoa, man, he was excited. Eve said nothing until something in her image was produced. And she said, wow,